Madam Chair.
Yes, sir.
I'm wondering if I can offer an amendment or ask the makers of the motion to amend the motion. With some of the information that Mr. Jones shared with us and understanding the process a little bit more clearly now, it would seem to me that rather than asking that the request from the selectmen be denied without us having all the information that I think we need, I think that maybe what would be better served for everyone here is that we ask, number one, we ask the selectmen or the acting town manager, if the request has not been filed yet, that they hold off on filing the request until such time they meet with us, or if the request has been filed, then we send the letter asking that they hold off on making a decision until such time as the selectmen can come and meet with us. And if we don't have that meeting, or you know, we get a chance to have it explained to us clearly on what that number is and why they need it, then we can take further action in sending a subsequent letter. But I think this gives both the Board of Selectmen and this board a chance to collaborate on this information. So I think it would be...
I'll second that amendment. I think that it offers an opportunity for more of a collaboration between boards and less of an adversarial position, which is what I think the intent is. So I very much endorse that and second that amendment.
I don't know you can offer an amendment on a motion that hasn't been acted upon.
Yes, you can.
Yes, sure.
It's the only time you can do it.
It's the only thing, right?
I mean, Mike made a motion. I seconded it. We had our discussion, and now you're making an amendment.
Correct.
Right.
Does Mike agree with the amendment?
That's what he has to do.
We're going
to
vote on the amendment, and then we'll vote on the motion.
Great.
Whether it's amended or not.
That's the process.
So you know you're going to vote on the amendment before you vote on the primary motion.
Correct.
Yes.
Correct.
Then if the amendment fails, then you're back to the original motion.
Yeah.
Boy, you guys.
I'd have to reword the motion.
Yeah. I think there's still it's a workable avenue in...
I think sending to the DRA to hold off is probably a good idea right away, because you don't know how long the rest of this will take internally.
Mm-hmm.
I have no problem with that part. The second part is a little more difficult for me to handle in view of some circumstances, but I'm willing to be flexible on the... Mm. Writing a letter to the DRA, I can actually just change. Well, I can't change the motion, can I? Without withdrawing the motion. Why don't I do this?
Well, we can ask for universal consent to table the amendment and the motion in preparation of listening to your new motion. How's that?
Want to do that?
No.
No.
If we're going to the same end,
I could withdraw the motion and then make substitute with that remark included.
Or we could simply ask you to restate your motion.
Yeah.
Want to restate the motion with that amendment and see if that meets?
Well, no, you have to do the amendment first.
Wait a minute. You have the motion. There's an amendment to the motion. The amendment to the motion has to be voted on first, or the amendment needs to be withdrawn.
Mm-hmm.
In which case, then it goes back to the motion. Have I got this straight?
Yeah.
No, if the motion is withdrawn, then the amendment disappears with it.
Yeah. Right.
Does it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It'll go back to
all right. So are you going to withdraw the original motion?
I'll withdraw that, and with the idea that I'll substitute with this DRA delay thing request.
Okay. So you have withdrawn your motion, and now you want the floor to make a new motion.
Either that or I can.
The second has to also withdraw.
No, it's not true.
No.
I withdraw,
Okay, so you're going to make a new motion? Go ahead.
Why don't we hear this amended motion again?
I'm going to make a new motion.
New motion.